aid of AIDS. The AIDS diet plan really works.
AIDS candy contains a safe and effective appetite suppressant when used as directed.
This week, we've got a special one. I'll be blindly reacting to some of the best and worst branding campaigns of all time. And as a professor of branding, we'll see how this goes. Oh, this is the Kindle. Yeah. I almost feel like this ad like went up to the largest Nickelback fan ever in the world and said, okay, I want you to visualize what cool people look like. I feel like that's what they did. Yeah, this is just Pepsi not reading the room. That they were trying to have a conversation of, you know, coming together in unity, which in a glittering generality form is a good conversation to have, right? Unity is important. But saying that your product, especially when it's a soft drink company or any product really whatsoever, your product's going to be the one thing that brings that unity and just bypasses the years and hundreds of years of issues when it comes to race in the United States, it's not gonna happen.
No, the day she put this in.
Maybe the weirdest ad campaign ever, Domino's bashes itself.
Worst, I remember this. This is the Domino's starts bashing their own
worst
pizza.
Or the best excuse for an ad
this
campaign.
Is a good one.
Domino's pizza crust to me is like cardboard.
The sauce tastes like ketchup.
Domino's wasn't very good. Pizza, one they've been selling us.
Now, this one is one of the best branding campaigns. Domino's really leaned into authenticity and telling kind of their stories from a genuine tone. It's very easy for them. They could have just come up with a campaign like many others come out with of, hey, we changed our recipe and we're changing our processes. We're new and we're fresh. No, they took shots of themselves before. They leaned into that. I mean, everyone else knew the elephant in the room. They were very transparent with it. And sort of they learned from their mistake.
New nose, $6,000. Lips, $3,000. New chest, $8,000.
I don't tell me. I never forget a face. Don't help me here.
It's amazing the changes you can make for a few thousand dollars.
Huh? Here's the mess up right here.
Bob Johnson?
Hi, Tom.
Imagine what Holiday Inn.
See, here's where this campaign really got off the rails. Is Holiday was trying to tell this story about how they're spending so much money to revamp their hotels. And in doing so, they really, what came across in this campaign was downplaying the bullying and the effects that the transgender community are facing when people look down upon them. And what you see literally in this ads of disgust, you see this from the individual's face at the end that he finds out that this was Bob. It's disgust on his face, really downplaying and making fun of the bullying that the transgender community really sees. Big fail. All right, we've got Christmas going on. I hope this is about the company that I think it is. Santa's gifts. Cookies. Yep. Let me guess. Coca-Cola. Absolutely. One of the best campaigns literally of all time. I'm such a fan of the Coca-Cola Santa campaign that I made a whole entire video about it. We'll try to link it so you can watch that whole entire video. Coca-Cola literally developed the image of Santa Claus that we use today. Now, they didn't invent Santa Claus, but the image, look at the color of the red that he uses. That red and that white, it's literally the colors of Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola invented that imagery. This is by far the best campaign of all time. Big fan. All right, what is... Okay. I know what this is. This one will go down as one of the worst campaigns of all time. All time. From an organization you wouldn't have thought of. organization you wouldn't have thought of doing something like this. This is actually the World Wildlife Foundation. The World Wildlife Foundation probably wishes they could have taken this one back. See, that's where they mess up right here. That's their thinking of putting this data and deaths into proportion with something that Americans have a strong emotional connection to. You just gotta read the room here. And you have to understand that there are certain topics that organizations just have to be super, super delicate about. When they were trying to compare apples to apples and to data points and death to death, you got to understand that emotional connection to certain events are incredibly high. Huge fail, probably one of the worst campaigns of all time.
Hard to understand how this made it past the pitch meeting. A slogan on bottles of Bud Light called it, quote, the perfect beer for removing no from your vocabulary for the night.
Absolutely. That was the Up For Whatever campaign that Budweiser had.
To sexual assault.
Critics saying it invites attacks on women.
I say it has a certain rapey feel to it.
Yeah, it just didn't hit the tone. They did not hit the tone. The amount of edits that need to go through some of these campaigns need to go through the eyes of multiple stakeholders, right? With something that one target market may not really connect with, another target market may see, especially with when we come to people of different sexes, different sexual orientations, different social economic backgrounds. We need people to step up and have what I call red teams to say, hey, this is something a little iffy. We need to look into this specifically, pull this a little bit more. This was a mess up of Anheuser-Busch.
Hi, I'm Mike, founder of DollarShaveClub.com. What is DollarShaveClub.com? Well, for $1 a month, we send high quality razors right to your door.
Like this.
Yeah, $1. Are the blades any good? No. Our blades are f-ing great. Each razor has stainless steel blades, an aloe vera lubricating strip, and a pivot head. It's so gentle a toddler could use it.
This video actually made the entire company. This video went so viral. People started sharing this video so much that it got them so much organic traffic and organic customers because of this. And you got to see, this is low budget. This was just pure creativity. Coming up with something new. There's been a lot of companies making parody videos of this exact same kind of theme to it. This is a classic. Absolute classic. It's a win.
Candy. And I'm not gaining weight. I'm losing weight deliciously with the aid of AIDS. The AIDS diet plan really works.
AIDS candy contains a safe and effective appetite suppressant when used as directed. Helps curb your appetite so you can lose weight. And AIDS candy has no stimulant that can make you nervous.
The plan lets you enjoy two AIDS before each meal. Mmm, delicious chocolate flavor. And I love being a size 10 again.
Lose weight deliciously with the aid of AIDS.
This is an issue with terminology. Obviously, in the 70s, when the AIDS epidemic became a large national and worldwide issue, anything with a similar name is going to, a lot of organizations have the same situation. If there's something of national value associated to a crisis and your name has something to do or sounds similar to that same thing, you're going to see the same case time over time again. Nothing they did wrong in this situation. They didn't do anything wrong. It was just unfortunate of the name that the candy had specifically. So there you go, a reaction to some of the best and worst branding campaigns of history. Now, this is a very small list. There are many, many more examples. So here's what I'm looking for you. In the comments this week, drop in the comments of this video, other campaigns, organizations, commercials that you've seen, whether they be amazing or absolutely awful. Drop them in the comments. I'll do another video in a couple of weeks and I'll use some of the examples from the comments of this video. I'll pull them up. My team and I will look at them and I'll blind react while watching some of those campaigns. Last week's video was about branding and Hallie has the comment of the week. I had never really thought about the importance of the post-purchase stage being so important. I think I would probably stick with recommending Apple to my closest friends because I personally love all the products. I look forward to seeing the campaigns or ads or promotions that you think are amazing or terrible in the comments of this video. But before then, we'll see you next week.